McDonald's 与您一起庆祝美国亚太裔传统月。
Toyota RAV4 新款油电混合汽车拥有比您想得更远的续航能力。
警察这个词并非是美国或是西方人发明的，其实在中国数千年的历史当中一直都有普利，竟然是与 police 是谐音的。在千百年来，中国人是信奉神明，有明确的道德约束，读书人更要熟读四书五经，道德始终是考虑观史的第一个原则。谦谦君子受到了崇尚，而社会道德的高尚也决定了社会的治安。古代甚至是没有特别详细的王法的，所谓县官要判案更得依据许多道德或是社会的准则，并非多么严谨的法律条文。现在道德的沦丧是否是导致社会治安的不断恶化呢？
这是我们的报警系统，看到这个系统可以随便拍一下。然后所有的报警系统呢，就是从报警电话都是从这个地方开始的。你看我们有大概一二三四个操作台，有五条线同时可以运转，在这基本上每一个工作的时间呢，都会有一个讲中文的，或者是如果没有的话，我们有一条专线是外语线，这样的话可以翻译报警。
这个是我们这个局的标志。我们是 Temple Five， 这些警员是为这个局牺牲的，在工作当中牺牲的这些人。
在这个会议室，你可以看到每个警员来了以后都要拿一个 In Service， 这边会告诉你都是谁在哪个区域巡逻。这样子的话呢，你接到报警电话就知道谁是你的拍档，谁会来帮助你在哪个方向过来，这样。很重要。
我们天普是有最多讲中文警官的警察局，所以这是其中一个。
然后你看现在的车都没有了，因为我们有一个重大案件在南边有一个枪杀案，所以基本上所有的车都去了。
现在在我身边的呢是 Temple City Sheriff Department 的刘警官 Aaron 刘。刘警官，我想请教一下您的每一天的 daily routine 大概是什么？
因为我是巡逻，这个巡逻队长，所以呢，我是所有路面上的事情都归我负责，所以我第一天每天来上班的第一件事呢，就是看一下我就是有多少警官在路面上。
嗯哼，除此之外啊，像您是从事了这个警察的工作，大概是多久的时间了？
12年。
哇，12年了，在12年当中，您都不会觉得辛苦吗？或者是如果您觉得辛苦，或是觉得生命受到威胁、有危险的时候，您是怎么 overcome 的？
其实，在你最紧张的时候，是在你进入这个危险状况的前一秒钟或者前五秒钟，这个心理是最紧张的。最好的解决办法呢，就是你平常的训练。你在平常训练了以后呢，因为我们有队形啊，有比较熟悉在什么样的状况需要怎么样的应对，这样的话呢，你有足够的信心。当你进入这个状况的时候，其实你就不紧张了。你的所有的注意力都在说你怎么样解决这个危险的状况，然后保住自己的性命。
对，这是非常重要的，因为在你保护别人的同时，你要保护到自己，自己当然是最为重要的。所以在这么长的12年的这样的我们所谓警察生涯当中啊，有没有什么事情让你觉得是最感到荣耀？Asian American be proud to be in the police force.
其实已经很荣耀了，很不容易。做一个亚裔的这个警官呢，是女性啊，是一个非常不容易的事情。你需要牺牲很多，比如说你的时间和家人的时间。对，因为我们是 24/7， 24小时连轴，365天，我没有机会跟家人过圣诞啊，或者这些节日，因为你总是在上班，对吧？这是比较辛苦的地方啊。荣耀的就是说，这个是很公平的竞争。公平就是说，你如果完成了他们所要求的训练，你就能成为一名警察，你就能坐到这个位置。这个是让我觉得很光荣的。
有没有什么想要对我们下一代的亚裔或是移民，让他们觉得其实在美国当警察也是一个非常荣耀的事情？
在美国当警察是一个非常荣耀的事情，这让你作为一个这个亚裔的后裔呢，有一种责任感，有一种社会的参与感。你在管理这个社会，你在就是在保护你的这个 community， 这个是让你感到非常荣耀的事情。我也为这个工作而感到骄傲。
在过去，亚裔族裔经常是默不作声的，反而是助长了这些的现象。发声才能够提高社会的意识，共同的面对问题。
Hi, Sheriff. Hi, Captain. How are you?
Hello.
Within Temple City Police Station, your jurisdiction extremely huge. May I know what are some of the cities that you cover?
Yes, absolutely. We cover South El Monte, Rosemead, Temple City, Duarte, Bradbury, the unincorporated areas of Monrovia, Arcadia, Duarte, North and South San Diego, East Pasadena, and the Chantry Flats area of the Angeles National Forest.
Majority of those cities has very, very high, I would say, condensed Asian citizens, Asian American citizens, starting from 2 years ago, which COVID has started, hate crime has started. Well, how do you determine what is a hate crime, Sheriff?
Well, hate crime is, there's two types. There's hate crimes and a hate incident. A hate incident could be maybe somebody yelling at you because you're of Asian descent and they make a disparaging comment, but that's it.That's a hate incident. But if they do that and then they assault you,
mm-hmm.
or they vandalize your home or something, now you have the incident coupled with a crime, now it becomes a hate crime as well, which is in addition to the base crime.
How, when we face that, even though that we probably won't be able to determine what's the major difference between either a hate incident or a hate crime, what can we do to protect ourselves?
The most important thing you need to do is you got to report it.Just because it may not be a crime, it might be an incident, still report it, because the people that are involved in hate incidents are your suspects in hate crimes later on, and we get to connect all the dots.
I see. Within that Temple City's website, I can see crime incidents are not recorded as much. Is it because it's not really happening within Temple City area, or is it because you guys are doing your job?
Well, it's probably a little bit of both. We do not have a large trend of Asian hate crimes in our area, thank God. Year to date, we've only had one incident, and even at that, this particular case involved an internet threat from an anonymous source to an Asian business. So there's no need to panic in the area. It's just not as prevalent as maybe going on somewhere else in other jurisdictions.
Mm-hmm. Hate crime or hate incident is not I wouldn't say serious. It is a serious issue. However, it's not really happening within Temple City at this moment. What kind of crime that is happening within your jurisdiction?
Oh, we have a variety, I'm pretty sure.
Yes, so we've got a rise in property crimes is the biggest rise in my jurisdiction.Burglaries in some of my areas are up as much as 165%. Grand theft autos are through the roof. And catalytic converter theft is a hot topic right now. So those are the major theft crimes is really what's spiking in my area.
Mm-hmm. How do you keep your jurisdiction safe and your citizens safe?
Well, there's a lot of things we need to be doing, and one, we have to keep pushing the Board of Supervisors to lift the hiring freeze so we can hire more people and hire from the community. I need to hire a lot more people of Asian descent that can speak Mandarin or Cantonese or can speak Korean, Japanese. We need to hire more in these languages, in these communities. One thing we're doing, we also have to have more patrol deputies out there, more detectives to solve the crimes that already occurred. Mm-hmm. There's a lot of things we can do at the station level on the prevention side.
Yes, absolutely. And to piggyback off that, we get out into the community and participate in a lot of community engagements, specifically with all of my nationalities that are in our area, but with the Asian community. I just did an event yesterday, mm-hmm. and I encourage the Asian community to really get out there and be in tune with what's happening, because a lot of times the Asian community is reluctant to call us for many reasons, what I've come to learn in my year and a half that I've been here, because they fear maybe we don't speak the language. But we have probably, I don't know the stats, maybe the sheriff knows, I believe I have probably the largest group of Asian deputies at my station who speak a variety of dialects. So that's not a problem to call the station, report incidents. Even if you're not a victim, if you're mm-hmm. if you're a witness, call yes. the station, because what is not, maybe it's not affecting you, but it could. It could.
The whole community.
Right. You're the eyes of the community. We have a large Asian population, so we rely on you to be good witnesses.
Yeah, we should be all a part of community.
停止仇恨亚裔运动出现于2021年，旨在谴责2019年冠状病毒大流行期间针对美国亚太裔岛民社群的暴力行为。这种谴责在许多的国家都发生了共鸣。在这些国家当中，除了针对亚洲人，还有亚裔的暴力行为也在增多当中，其中就包括了致命的攻击、言语，还有人身骚扰、校园霸凌、工作场所甚至是歧视，在媒体还有社会媒体平台的掺授仇恨，这些都不会是解决之道。只有通过公正、团结、友爱之墙，我们才能够赢得这一场反对仇恨的斗争。
缺乏沟通使这个社会对亚裔群体的缺乏了解是很多社会冲突的根源。作为巡逻队长，我会带领我们的警员在亚太裔传统月更多的深入到亚洲的亚裔社区，为亚裔的居民服务。在此同时呢，我也请亚裔居民跟我们联系，然后呢说出自己的想法和立场，我们的合作才能够建立一个更好的社区服务的体系。
And as we know, the month of May is Asian American Pacific Islander Awareness Month, and I encourage the AAPI communityto get involved with law enforcement. We are your friends. Make sure you report incidents, either if you're the victim of an incident or even a witness of an incident. Do not be afraid to call 911 for emergencies or call the local business line at 285-7171.
McDonald's 与您一起庆祝美国亚太裔传统月。
Toyota RAV4 新款油电混合汽车拥有比您想得更远的续航能力。
让您轻松拥有 Toyota 一路精彩。